response to and is dependent on this bodily nature. In one respect, the physical body is equal. capabilities are quite like the ones we can acquire during our lifetime. Take the case of a genius, for instance. As a bold Mozart could write down in memory a long piece of music he had heard only once. He was able to do so only because he could survey the whole thing all at once, as a totality. In the course of our lifetime, we can all, at least within certain limits, broaden our capacity to gain an overview of things and to understand the relationships between them. We then possess new abilities. Lesson, for example, said that through his gift for critical observation, he had acquired something very close to genius. If we are not inclined to see such abilities, rooted in inborn potential, as miracles, we must see them as the fruits of what the spirit self has experienced through the soul. They have been impressed upon the spirit self, and since it did not happen in this lifetime, it must have happened in a previous one. Destiny and reincarnation of the spirit alone. Each human spirit is a species in its own right. Just as individual human beings pass on their characteristics, the spirit passes on its characteristics within its species and credits within itself. In each life, the human spirit appears as a repetition of itself, with the fruits of its experiences in earlier lifetimes. Thus, this lifetime is the repetition of others, and brings with it what the spirit self has gained in its previous life. When the spirit self takes in something that can develop into fruit, it imbues itself with the life spirit. Just as the life body reproduces the form of a species from generation to generation, the life spirit reproduces the soul from one personal existence to the next. The discussion up to this point has shown the validity of the idea that certain processes in human life can be explained in terms of repeated earth lives. The core significance of this idea can be realized only through the kind of observation that stems from spiritual insights such as those acquired by following the path to knowledge described at the end of this book. It should be pointed out that ordinary observation, properly guided by thinking, can lead us to this idea, although to begin with a preliminary idea in a shadow-like state and will not be able to defend it completely against the objections that arise from imprecise observation not properly guided by thinking. On the other hand, anyone who comes to this idea through ordinary thoughtful observation is preparing for supersensible observation by beginning to develop something we must have before supersensible observation can be real, just as we must have eyes before physical observation is possible. And people who object that by conceiving it. 18. 82 Theosophy. Idea like this we could talk ourselves into believing in the reality of supersensible perception, only prove themselves incapable of really taking up the truth through independent thinking, they are talking themselves into believing their own objections. 19. In this way the soul's experiences become lasting, not only within the confines of birth and death but also beyond death. But the soul imprints these experiences not only on the spirit lighting up within it, but also, by means of its actions, on the outer world, as has been pointed out. What someone did yesterday is still present today in the form of its effects. Along these lines, result of many